I, Dr. Leena Chandani, Associate Professor, Head Department of English, Dada Ramchand Bapu Sindhu Mahavidyalaya, welcome you all on the second day, third session of the 3 days international conference on the novel and fresh theme, effective visualization and literature. Friends, many interesting, stimulating and inspiring sessions have been conducted since yesterday, and we all are enjoying this literary feast, isn't it? Yet another session is being conducted now. We have with us eminent guest, Honorable Dr. Archana Bahadur Jassy, a multi-talented personality. She's a writer, poet, counselor, translator, researcher, and scholar par excellence. Dr. Archana has taught at some renowned institutions of Lucknow. She's the counselor in English with Indira Gandhi National Open University. Archana ji has detailed literary interviews, and they have appeared in the print by the Post Magazine UK 21st Century Critical Thought Volume. Madam has done her BEd from Central Institute of Education, Delhi University, and NET and PhD in English. Her research is on the poetry of Philip Larkin and Nassim Ezzetil. Dr. Archana ma'am has 3 volumes of poetry. Poetic Candor is her debut collection of poetry in 2018, The Speaking Muse in 2019, Careless Verse Whispers, Kindle 2021 are available on Amazon. Meerabai the Legend, A Life and Struggle as a Woman, a novel translated by her from Hindi to English, is also available on Amazon and Kindle. Her poems feature in many anthologies like Colors of Life, Zindagi Ke Rang, Feel Not Just Free, Essence of a Woman, Lockdown 2020, Mother's Anthology, Born to Dream Winners, A New Dawn, The Kali Project Anthology, and many more. She has several research papers and poems published in journals and books. We are really privileged to have her as our resource person. Welcome, ma'am. We also will have with us another eminent personality, Honorable Dr. Arvind Navle, sir. Sir is the Associate Professor and Head Department of English, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, Udyog District, Lucknow. Sir has been NCC Commission Officer, Poet Commander, Last Rank Captain for the last 10 years, Head Department of English for the last 15 years, former Coordinator, Next Steering Committee at IQSE. Sir has worked as member of the Senate, SRTM University, Nanded, member of Board of Studies in English, Member Faculty of Arts, Chairman, Member of Application Committee, Business Board Member Selection Committee, External Examiner PhD Work, Life Member Association for English Studies in AESI. Arvind sir has also total 45 books to his credit and has co-edited almost 9 books and some 34 anthologies. Out of 45 books, near about 30 books are subscribed by the world's more than 167 renowned overseas libraries, including USA, UK, South Africa, Australia, Germany, France, Canada, and many more. Sir has presented many research papers at national and international level and has published the research papers in reputed journals and books. He has delivered several talks, guest lectures, and literary interviews. We are fortunate to have such versatile personality with us. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Leena ji.
Thank you, sir.
The resource person, respected Professor Archana ji Jassy ma'am from Lucknow, the management authorities and principals of Prerana College of Commerce, Dayanand Arya Girls College, and DRBS College Nagpur, and Porwal College, Kamti. The chief convener and a very good and great friend of mine, Dr. Praveen G. Jassy, Dr. Snehal ma'am, rest conveners, and organizing committee members of 3-day mega international conference on effective visualization and literature, and esteemed participants who are accessing this event through Zoom as well as YouTube live streaming. A very good afternoon to one and all. At the outset, I would like to appreciate the talk delivered by Professor Archanaji on reality and fantasy in drama. I found in her talk an effective fusion of plenary talk with conference topic, that is effective visualization in literature. She is a creative poet with a good number of volumes to her credit, and as she is accustomed with poetry recitation, she has presented her topic with proper sound pattern, gestures, which visualized an effective picture among us about Shakespeare's plays and his use of fantasies. Friends, in context of literature, visualization is a technique for creating images or a series of mental images to communicate a message more effectively, and is being used in all forms of literature since ancient time. With it, you learn to look beyond the superficial meanings and go deeper into the text. From the 20th century, it has expanded further into various forms of media, and now we see it is being used in video games too since last few decades. Visualizing strengthens effective comprehension of the literary text and helps for richer reading experience. As far as reading drama or watching a dramatic performance of any play on the stage is concerned, it refers to dramatist's ability to create a picture or a series of pictures in the minds of readers or the spectators based on the text they read or words they hear. Visualizing creates personal links between the readers, listeners, and the context. Even a well-crafted sentence or dialogue can provide a rich springboard for visualizing effect. And it is wonderfully explained by Professor Archanaji with case study of Shakespeare's Julius Caesar, Hamlet, Merchant of Venice, Macbeth, Tempest, and so on, citing many events and dialogues, some soliloquies also of these renowned plays. Fantasy is something that is produced by the imagination, an idea about doing or explaining something exciting, unusual, or pleasant, that is, in almost cases, far removed from normal reality. It is the creation of the imaginative faculty, whether expressed or perceived or conceived. Most dramatists use magical or other supernatural elements in their main plot to create it. This differs from realistic drama, where dramatist has to adhere to the history and natural law of reality, where fantasy does not. In fantasy, the dramatist has to rely on the readers or the spectators' expectations, their acceptance of the unbelievable or impossible for the sake of enjoyment, and create character, situation, and setting that are not possible in some senses in real world. Fantasy is a phenomenon that has a strong presence in our day-to-day life. It tends to accentuate only its entertaining and leisurely aspects, presenting it as something unserious, somewhat irrational in some cases, and escapist. However, fantasy is also tied into the performance of reality through its explicitly reflective nature that pushes reader or the spectators to become aware of the real ethical world, though somewhat sometime utopian in some senses. The aura of the realism of any fictional world is that, or the dramatic world is that, the result of the reader's unconscious decision to believe that what they see is true and actually exists, or at least maybe so. Entertainment-driven fantasy allows momentary attainment of personal desire, while such exploration-driven fantasy confronts real-world problems and offers solutions through element of fantasy which leads to long-term benefits through reflective learning, as we see in Aesop's Fables or the Arabian Nights, or as man has very wonderfully emphasized on World Word that Shakespeare liberates it. The liberal use of Shakespeare in his plays, liberal use of fantasy. The visualization in the mind of reader or the spectators occurs when a mental image is formed while you read a text or watch a stage performance in which a place, situation, person, animal, concept or thing is described, and your mind forms a mental image of it that allows you to see beyond it. Fantasy, unlike other devices and techniques, tickles and awakens your sensory perception, ignites kinesthetic sensations also. You would mentally zoom in and out that picture and come up with an explanation for the same, as Dr. Archanaji presented a picture of Julius Caesar, Hamlet, Antonio, Macbeth, Banquo, Prospero and so on, by quoting many dialogues and some popular soliloquy put in their mouth by Shakespeare. I am very impressed by her reciting the soliloquy, tomorrow, tomorrow and tomorrow. Life is a tale told by an idiot signifying. Literature has always been an attractive media to illustrate a wide range of representations of life. As seemingly simple plot line can be made into fantasy. By removing the limitations of reality, fantasy opens stories to the possibility of anything. For example, Harry Potter, Kipling's Jungle Book, in which the authors put magical element therein and blend it naturally with the reality of life in some senses. Tennessee Williams, streetcar named Desire, buckets some absurd plays, and as stated by Madam, Shakespeare's some plays are a very good example of it. The people of Shakespeare's time believed in ghosts. The ghost of the murderer, the king, starts the action in the Hamlet. Brutus is visited by the ghost of the friend he helped assassinate in Julius Caesar, who refers to him as an evil spirit and predicts Brutus' imminent death. A Midsummer Night's Dream is surely the most magical of Shakespeare's play. It counts seven named fairy characters among its cast. They are proud, Oberon, beautiful, Titania, and mischievous Puck, and so on. This supernatural brings drive the action, drawing two pairs of young lovers into the cagiest love continued of all time. Shakespeare offers fantasies that are at once more relevant to reality, and as stated by ma'am, I would like to repeat that, liberating them from the term escapist fantasy. Due to the sparsity of time, I would like to sum up. Professor Archanaji has very meticulously analyzed and pointed out the correlation of fantasy and reality and its function. The effective visualization has got reflected in Shakespeare's select dramas. Once again, I congratulate her for wonderful talk, presentation, which has made addition in knowledge of most of us. We are running out of time. I'm supposed to close this session, as time allotted for our session is over, and panelist of next session, Dr. Rivera of Tarlac State University, Philippines, and my very good and great friend, Dr. Jagdeep Sarangi from Kolkata, are waiting in Zoom rooms. Thank you, organizing committee of this mega 3-day international events, for organizing such wonderful event, which is truly international in its standard. I would like to conclude with special thanks to my friend and brother, Dr. Praveen Joshi, a man who is partially in front, however fully behind curtain, with his flesh and blood, verve and enthusiasm. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, Arvind Navle, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, please.
You have expressed your views in a very expressive way. Thanks for your kind words. Thanks for your appreciation. Thank you so much, Archana ma'am. Now I request Nehal to propose a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Lina ma'am. Good afternoon to all. I'm Snehal Rakunde, assistant professor from Prerana College of Commerce, Nagpur. It's my honor to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of four colleges. First of all, I would like to give special thanks to our eminent resource person, Professor Archana Jussi ma'am, who has excellently guided the participants and shared her valuable knowledge with us. Ma'am, your talk on the topic reality and fantasy in drama was really full of informative. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to acknowledge our sense of gratitude to the respected chairperson, Dr. Arvind Namle, sir, for wonderfully summing up the session. Thank you, sir. I am also thankful to all the participants who have supported with full of zeal and zest for making this session successful. Thank you all. Here we end today's third session.